plant genetic transformation. All stable transformation methods consisting of three steps: delivery of DNA into single plant cell, integration of DNA into the plant cell genome, conversion of the transformed cell into whole plant. Agrobacterium mediated transformation. Only known natural example of DNA transport between kingdoms. In this virulent strains of 8 tumefaciens contains 200 kb tumor inducing Ti plasmid. Bacteria transfers a portion of the plasmid DNA into plant host tDNA. The Agrobacterium tumefaciens will infect the dicotyledonous plants. Bacteria entering stem or root through wound. Bacteria multiplies and spread the intercellularly, and finally it forms the crown gall-like structures. Infects at root crown or just below the soil line. Can survive the bacteria independently of plant host in the soil. Infects the plants through breaks or wounds. Common diseases of wound: woody shrubs, herbaceous plants, dicot. Galls are spherical rod-like structures similar to tumors. So this infection will be takes place only through the cuts. So this is the scanning electron microscopic view of the Agrobacterium tumefaciens. The tDNA is transferred from the bacteria into the nucleus of the plant. Stably integrates into the plant genome. Expression of genes in wild-type tDNA results in dramatic physiological changes to the plant cell. Synthesis of the plant growth hormones like auxins and cytokines, it forms the a tumor formation will be takes place. So this is the crown gall formation in the dicotyledonous plants. So we know that the bacteria containing in the form of the genomic DNA and in addition to the a plasmid DNA, that is what Ti plasmid. Genes required to break down the opines are used as a nutrient source for harbored on the Ti plasmid, in addition to with genes essential for the excision and transport of the tDNA to wounded plant cell. This is the overall structure of the Ti plasmid in the form of 200 kb. Containing a tDNA 23 kb. In addition, we have the weak genes for useful for the transfer to the plant. And in addition, we can see the opine catabolism genes in this plasmid. So we can see there are three genes which are useful from the genomic DNA, which are bind to the bacteria on the cell surface, that is in the form of CHV A and B and polysaccharide synthesizing gene A. tDNA inserts into plant genome. The vir genes, virulent genes, which activates the makes the neck and right and left borders of the tDNA. Origin for replication oocyte. This is overall Ti plasmid structure, and the tDNA consisting of three genes: oncogenes in the form of the auxin production and cytokines, and opine synthesis, it consisting of right and left borders, and virulent region, which is useful to make the nick the DNA and to transport into plant cell. And also we can see the other genes in the form of opine synthesis and opine catabolism and origin for replication. This is the wild TI plasmid. And we can make wild into the form of the normal plasmid in the form of the, we can delete auxin production, cytokinin production and opine synthesis will be deleted in this region of the TI plasmid, and also not required opine catabolism. Origin for replication, virulent region. This is the TI plasmid structure. And agrobacterium can be used to transfer the DNA into plants. So, co-integrated TI plasmid, plant cell. TI plasmid and the bacterial chromosomes act in concert to the transformation of the plant. Agrobacterium tumefaciens chromosomal genes in the form of CHV, A, B, and polysaccharide synthesis required for initial binding of bacterium to the plant cell and code polysaccharide on bacterial surface. Virulence region carried on TI plasmid but not transferred the region tDNA genes code for the proteins that prepare the tDNA and bacterium for the transfer. tDNA encodes genes for opine synthesis and for tumor production. Opine catabolism genes carried on TI plasmid allow the bacterium to utilize the opines as nutrients. Generation of the T strand. We can see the TI plasmid which is containing the tumor inducing region in the form of right and left border. And whenever the virulent regions with genes activated by the one of the plant products in the form of the histosyringones which are released from the cut ends of the plant surface. Virulent D nicks the lower strand of the T strand at the right border sequence and binds to the 5 end. And helicase unwinds the T strand which is then coated by the virulent E proteins T strand produced per cell. One T strand produced per cell. Strand coated with virulent E protein, virulent D nicks the left border, transfer to plant cell, second strand synthesis, integration into the plant chromosome. So whatever the single strand is generated will be converted to, will be transported into plant cell and it will be converted into double strand and now it is integrated into the plant chromosome. So whatever the cut ends of the plant surface, or if you make in plant tissue culture in the form of the leaf disc, in the form of the round leaves, in case of the dicot ligands, one of the chemical compound which is synthesized or released in the form of the acetosyringone. This acetosyringone which activates the wild genes. So whatever the virulent D and C which makes the nick at the right and left border and virulent E proteins which binds the single stranded DNA. Whatever the single stranded tDNA which is transported into plant cytosol and it will be converted double stranded DNA and it is integrated into the in the form of the plant genome and it will synthesizing the different kinds of the genes. So this is the overall transport of the tDNA from the Agrobacterium tumefaciens to the a single cell and integration into the plant genome. TI based vector for plant transmission. Settle vector is a small E. coli plasmid using for cloning the foreign genes and transferring into agrobacterium. Early settle vector integrated into tDNA still produced to tumors. E. coli conjugation agrobacterium integrated from the small vector. So transformation of the Arabidopsis plants detergent added to allow bacteria to infiltrate the floral meristem. Dip the floral buds in 1 ml of Acrobacterium culture 5 to 15 minutes. Transformation of the Arabidopsis plants 700 to 900 seeds per plant. Germinate on canamycin plants to select these transplants. 10 to 20 transformed plants with the wherever the gene transferred that will be germinated, rest won't be germinated, which is having the canamycin antibiotic resistant. Mini TI plasmid tDNA based vector for plants. Disarmed vectors do not produce any tumors, can be used regenerate the normal plants containing the foreign gene. The binary vector with genes required for the mobilization and transfer to the plant reside on the modified TI plasmid. Second, consisting of right and left border sequences, a selectable marker gene, canamycin resistant gene, and a polylinker that is useful to insert the gene of our interest. So this is a mini TI plasmid which is containing origin for replication, left and right border, and canamycin resistant gene and a polylinker. So another this plasmid tDNA deleted, not having the only virulent region in this plasmid, origin for the replication. Instead of a single plant, single plasmid, we can have the two plasmids in the form of the binary vector. One of the vector is containing tDNA, another vector which is containing the vir regions. Alternative methods of transferring plants, particle bombardment. In this, we can transport the DNA by using gas acceleration, a microtire carrier, stopping screen, and target cells DNA coated with microcarriers. One way of physically introducing DNA into cells with a particle gun, very tiny DNA coated with metal particles are suspended in a drop on microprojectile. Discharge the explosion from a breakage of the membrane enclosing pressurized chamber implies the microprojectile. The microprojectile is stopped by stopping plate, but the microprojectile continues into tissue below. The DNA introduced with particles is expressed. This is the overall view of the particle gun, and this is the particle gun. DNA RNA coated with tungsten particles loaded with gun and pull the trigger.